So, I'm in college, and I'm doing a paper on the high school years, before the military. You know the years you wanted to be over and move on to college or work, despite everyone telling you you will enjoy those years. Be grateful, you'll miss them. You look back on them and wish you could do it all over. Our response always was, yeah, right, whatever, no I won't. Well, I guess it's true, what they say. Wisdom does come with age, and they were right, and I was wrong. I do miss those years. I love to put a football uniform on and shoot a three-pointer as the crowd went crazy. I'm not going to lie, but at the same time, I'm going to try to do this without trying to be conceited. I was a popular kid who was in the so-called in crowd. I was a jock and was an average student. I could not stand homework or test. I just wanted to get through it and pass, just enough to play sports. Obviously, looking back, it wasn't the brightest thing to do. But who cares, though? I was popular, always had a girlfriend, and life was good. No cares and no worries in the world. I had a little secret in high school that a lot of people only found out when they got their high school yearbook and could not believe it. A jock that was good at football and great at basketball was on the chess team. I know, right? You're probably thinking one word, what? When I was a young kid around the third and fourth grade, my sisters had to walk me home and they were already in high school. Sometimes I had to wait for my sisters because they were on the class team, making it look good for when they applied to college. So I would have to sit around and wait for them. I wasn't about to be bored, so I picked it up at a young age and loved the strategy game. Over time, it got really good at chess, and before you know it, I was winning huge chess tournaments. So a lot of my close friends will still call me a geek. I worked only a weekend job at this place called Acme Ice. I shoveled dry ice for hours into 50-pound boxes, then picked them up, put them into a bin over and over and over again. Not really exciting or best wintertime job, but awesome during the summer. That's also when I discovered that Harvard students are airheads and went over and over again. Not really exciting or best wintertime job, but awesome during the summer. That's also when I discovered that Harvard students are airheads, and when you take a book away from them, all I have to say is, wow. I'm telling you, I'm not the brightest bulb in the world, but common sense goes a long way. Why I joined the military? It's a question I don't really think of, and definitely not a decision I regret, but when you ask me why I joined the armed forces, it's an answer I can definitely tell you. I signed up April 14, 2004, the day after my birthday, for the United States Air Force. It didn't matter what branch I served, I looked and talked to every recruiter. It wasn't for the pay or health plan, it was just for me. To be independent and live my life on my own without handouts. My family is pretty well off. You can kind of say I'm the black sheep of the family for going into the military. I'm the youngest of six, and my brothers and sisters all attended college and have outstanding well-paying jobs, from a doctor to fiber optic technician. My father pushed school on everyone and he wanted everyone to be successful. I know that's great, but I would see how he would remind my brothers and sisters that he paid for their education, no student loans, and they didn't have to work for anything. I didn't want that. I didn't want my father to always throw it in my face. I didn't want him to tell me that he did everything for me. I wanted to be able to do things for myself, pay for my own schooling, and live my life the way I wanted to. He and the rest of my family didn't understand that at the time. They definitely understand me more now and support me in my accomplishments in the armed forces. I knew I always wanted to join. There was just something about it that attracted me into it. It was the challenge. I was brought up very old school Irish Catholic. I am very disciplined and respectful. I didn't need the military to teach me what I already had. I just needed to see what I mentally could handle and what I could not. A mental challenge. I was only a sophomore when 9/11 happened, but that was around the time I was telling my family that I wanted to join the armed forces. September 11th was the deal breaker. When that tragedy happened, I knew I wanted to serve my country. I'm currently still in the Army National Guard. I just recently served in Iraq and would agree that the armed forces is not for everyone. But I personally do not regret a single decision I have made. What am I doing now? Some may say it's unfortunate that I am still in the Army National Guard. Believe me, some days I think the same thing. I'm currently a team leader in the National Guard. I have two privates under me, and each and every day I get a little more responsibility. The Army and I have a love-hate relationship. I'm always miserable when I have to go to my drill weekend, but once I get there, I see all my friends, and then the feeling dies down. One day I say I'm done with the Army once my contract's up, And other days I say, I'm just going to do my 20 years and collect the pension. It's a very confusing game that my mind and emotions play. I think the only thing that is stopping me from doing the 20 years is the army bullshit. If you're a soldier or in the military in general, you know what I'm talking about. It's unfortunate that we'll always be there, so I don't know what's going on with that. I recently got back from Iraq in November 2009. I was just hanging out and readjusting to the civilian life again, which some days I still find myself doing. You grow up fast in the military, especially coming back from a deployment. When you come home and you go to school with people that just graduated high school, you just see all the immaturity and can't understand that you were once that kid. Adapt and overcome is what I was taught, and so that is what I will continue to do. I'm attending school and I'm trying to take on just what I think I can handle right now. I'm having to take it slow because it's been a while since I have been in a classroom, and I also work a 40-hour job. I try and do the Army part-time. School and work is not the easiest to accomplish, as well as deal with any personal problems and issues, especially the girlfriend issues. I'm a very mature guy who is focused in life and knows the path I'm going to go down. I am a criminal justice major, and I hope to become a cop someday. If it happens, it happens. I've been taking as many civil service tests I can, whether it's the fire department or Department of Corrections. All I know is no matter where my life takes me, or bridges or hoops I need to go over and through, I will come out happy and successful. Currently right now, I'm working down at Fampier Boston as a director of security and absolutely love my job. It's just something I fell into and I couldn't ask for anything more. It pays the bills and for right now, I'm very content.